Good morning. Happy, happy Tuesday. Oh, it is such a blessing to see you walk in the door one at a time and to take your seats in this beautiful circle that we have, this community circle. So welcome. If this is your first time, glad that you are here. If you've come other times, welcome back. And a special thank you to those folks who weren't able to make it last week, but sent me a message. They said, I'll be there. I'll be there for the water. So I truly treasure you being here. So let me know if I speak too loudly, okay? Because I tend to get riled up in a good way and all energized. So just say, Elizabeth, hush a little bit. All right, so I hope that our time together is everything that each of us needs it to be. If you've come in here needing comfort, reassurance, if you need a sense of hope, if you are in any way stressed or worried or anxious, may each of us who need those things find relief. Maybe you've come in here today just needing a smile or a spark or just some fun or community, and I hope you find that too. Well, let's take a look at the first page of our handout and see what we're all about this morning. So it says, Water of Life. So I looked up water just to see how many times it was in the Bible. 722 references. We could go in 722 different directions today, but I chose three different directions. But it's all the way from Genesis all the way through Revelation. Water flows through all of Scripture, and it talks to us about its importance for us spiritually and physically. So our paragraph on the first page says, human beings have long been in awe of water. It cleanses and hydrates, it produces nourishment, and it is a sacred resource of our planet. 70% of the world is covered by water, and 2/3 of the human body consists of water. It's about 70%. World is 70% water. Our bodies are 70% water. Then I wrote, we'll gather on this day with music, song, and scripture, celebrating the presence of refreshing and renewing water in our lives. So, my dear friends, what has been very, very meaningful for me, if you've been here for one or two of the last sessions, is at the beginning, we pass this microphone. And if you have the courage, that's because it's not easy to talk in the microphone, but if you have the courage to say your name, because I've learned a lot about you, who you are, from you saying your names. However, today, let's do something a little extra when you say your name. When the person is saying their name, everybody, let's send them love, joy, peace. Let's celebrate who they are. So when the person says their name, just smile at them or send a quick prayer. That is really cool because I think the person who's saying it will know. On some cellular level, they will sense. And when you're saying your name, how powerful will it be when you know that everybody in this room is sending you love, joy, and peace, and good health? Okay? here we go. I'm going to start because I want to be bathed in your good prayers and wishes. So my name is Elizabeth Scrivener. Would you start?
My name is Jane Scott, and I look forward to this morning with great joy.
My name is Jean Harrell, and I'm glad to be here this morning with hope.
My name is Bertie Ryan.
I'm glad to be here.
My name is Peggy Maxwell.
And I'm Virginia Davis. And I'm happy to be here this morning.
Oh, I feel the love going around this circle.
And I'm Myra Nagel. My name is Nancy Van Rocken. I love Elizabeth's classes and I love to sing. And we had a lot of water this week, Elizabeth. I can't think of anything than talking about water, even though right now after exercise class I'm thirsty and I talk too much, so love me anyway. Bye.
My name is Nancy Lee.
I am Simone Coleman.
Martha Robertson.
Faith Cars.
Sarah Sykes.
My name is Don Branson.
I'm Bill Stevenson.
We have this other class behind. Sending love and the light.
Howard and Kelly, and I'm
you.
Don't send me away.
You are most welcome. I'm glad you're here. And Margaret, you're here. So let's send Margaret love. Stars, fire. a beautiful song of praise. The third verse, look at that. Cool flowing water, pure and clear, make music for all life to hear. So let's sing this together. If you know it, join in. If you don't know it, join in. If you get the sense of it after the first verse, you know. And if you're not in the mood to sing today, you just need to be bathed in just sound and love and light, that's all right. We'll take care of it. We got this for you. Let everyone who can and who wishes to, let's sing All Creatures of the Earth and Sky. And you know, I think after we sing our third verse, I'm going to play another verse instrumentally on the piano, because I feel like music can certainly help us center, meditate, and bring us peace. So after we finish the third verse, I'm just going to gently add some stuff, okay? And I invite you to use that for your whatever way is meaningful to you. Here we go, my friends. All creatures of the earth and sky.
Thank you.
praise and gratitude for another day, another clean slate, right? Today, we're like artists of a new day. We create this day any way that we want. That's reason to sing hallelujah or hallelujah. All right, let's go to scripture passage number one. And there are three scripture passages today. This is from Genesis 1. It is verses 1 through 10. And I asked Myra to read this for us today. She read Genesis last week. And so I asked her to proclaim this today. Myra?
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was formless and void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the night light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good.
God saw that it was good. Mother, thank you so much. A beautiful reading. There's so much in this passage, and you can take it home and you can meditate and reflect on it. But a couple of things I want to just expound on because they struck me. First is that isn't God like the cosmic artist? You know, oh, just what a great image. However you think of God. God, cosmic artist, the artist of all creation. Started in the void, started in nothing, and created just amazing things for us. The second thing that pops out is all of these images. So first one is that there was darkness, or there was a void. And God brought in light. Haven't you always wondered why God didn't say, "Be gone, darkness, never show your face again, I don't want to see you"? Things that make you go, right? God didn't say, "Be gone forever, you have no place." And God balanced the darkness and the light. Oh, we could spend a whole hour on just that concept, right? Last week we talked about the bulb. The bulb of the flower has to go into the darkness in order to sprout. So that's just one thing. Now, the next thing that struck me is when God created the waters. Right, so first the waters, it says that there's a dome. I don't say what kind of dome. In this particular translation. And then it seems like the waters go this way. The waters appear vertically first. God separates the waters from maybe mist. Maybe there was some mist that came out of the waters. And then the last paragraph, God separates the waters horizontally this way. And wasn't there land? Fascinating. Fascinating to me. And God saw that it was good. That brings up the question. God's creation and think it's good. There is this term that I love, and I'll just share it with you. It's called baby eyes. It's a challenge to look at the world through baby eyes. If you've ever seen a young child, especially a toddler, look up at something for the first time, the wide eyes, the wonder, the awe, the surprise, that, I've heard, is the way to live. You know, I know if I've gotten a little older, I lose those baby eyes. I see a beautiful flower arrangement, or I see this beautiful group of people, and boy, I see this beautiful mountain, and I really have to ask myself, am I looking at that with new eyes and fresh eyes and eyes of praise, eyes of gratitude? So I offer the challenge to myself, and if you want to take this challenge too, that we go out of here today and we look at everything and everyone with baby eyes once again. Let's look at this bowl right here. All right, right now it's an empty bowl. But, you know, I wanted to bring water, our friend water, to sing for us today. Would be right to talk about water, but to have our baby eyes to look at this with awe and wonder. So I'm going to invite the water in here to sing for us. And let's experience this with wonder and awe and gratitude in whatever way that is for you. God's water, the water of life. Praise and thanks for water. You know, my favorite sound, even as a musician, is a Connecticut babbling brook. I grew up in Connecticut. My favorite sound is just sitting by a babbling brook and allowing that sound to bathe over me. You know, I try to come up with as many possible descriptions for water as I could. And I'm sure that you would come up with more, but I'm gonna zoom through these, okay? And I zoom through them because, as we heard in our introduction, this planet is made up of 70% water because of, here I go, puddles, oceans, seas, lakes, ponds, rivers, streams, wetlands, creeks, coves, lagoons, marshes, springs, swamps. I'm about halfway done. All right. Bays, bayous, brooks, canals, channels, coves, distributaries, estuaries, gulfs, harbors, inlets, reservoirs, straits, tide pools, raindrops. Then there's frozen water like snow and ice. And then there's like steam and fog and clouds. Whew. 70%! And I'm sure there's others that I didn't mention. But I hope it made you go, yeah, I kind of knew that, but hearing it today, that gives me a new perspective on it. I love that. You know, our musical world has tried to create sounds like nature. Have you ever seen a rain stick? All right, so this is a musical instrument. Inside is either rice or seeds, and as they fall, they hit little sticks in there and they make a sound. So I don't know if this sounds like rain or not, but it's called a rain stick, and they try to make this sound like rain. Let's listen and see. As we appreciate rain, like yesterday, you were saying you picked up your handout yesterday. You looked out the window immediately and it was pouring rain. So musical instruments that sound like rain. That's kind of cool, isn't it? What's one? Rainstorm was a little shorter than the other. These can be purchased at music stores and certainly online. I use this particular one for reflection and meditation. If I need to breathe, like last week we talked about breathing in a flower and then blowing out a candle. You know, that breathing in, breathing out. That's what I use this for. Breathe in when it goes one way, breathe out. So this might make a nice gift for you to ask for Hanukkah or for Christmas or birthday.
Had a stick, would you say it was?
Rain stick?
Rain
stick. Yes, rain stick. Now you gotta bear with me here, okay? Because we're gonna do something which you might think is goofy, but I don't think it's goofy. I think it's fun. All right. So right now we're talking about our appreciation and gratitude for the water around us. So I think it's time for the Cedarfield rainstorm right here. You might have done this already. So very simply, I'm going to go around the circle, and whatever I do in front of you, you do. So if I do this, you would do that. And keep on going. As I pass you, keep on going. I'm going to go around and you do what I do. Keep on going. And then I'm going to get to you again and I'll change it. But only you change it. And change it when I come to you. You're all doing this and you're going to be doing something different. The idea is, I don't know if it's going to work or not, but it is supposed to sound like a rain shower. How many of you have done this before? Let's see if it works, Myra, okay? All right. And if you don't feel up to participating, no problem. All right, here we go. Do you all do this? Keep on going. Good. Keep on going. Keep on going. So that sounds like a little bit of rain starting. You keep on going, okay? Alright. You start this. You guys keep going and rubbing. Alright. Now rubbing and snapping. Pretty soon it'll start like a rainstorm. Little bit of raindrops. jump for joy. That was good. Give yourselves a high five. Good job. So, baby eyes. We had awe and wonder at what we just did. So that's the wonder of water around us. Now let's look at the wonder of water within us. Okay, let's go on to our next scripture passage, number 2. Is there someone here who would like to read Jeremiah 17, verses 7 and 8? Wonderful, thank you.
Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in God. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. Does not fear when heat comes. Its leaves are always green. Has no worries in a year of drought and never fails to bear fruit.
Oh, powerful. Powerful reading. Thank you so much. So, once again, our first scripture reading was about the wonders of water in creation. This one, let's look at the wonders of water within our bodies. So we have this reading from Jeremiah that we heard so beautifully proclaimed. From what I understand, Jeremiah is often spoken about as the reluctant prophet. He didn't want to be a prophet. He said, I'm too young. I'm too inarticulate. But he did. He accepted the call. He accepted God's call. And this first line, he says, blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in God. So we've talked, if you've been here the last couple weeks, a lot about trusting during times of doubt, and times of fear, times of worry. And as I look around, I see faces, and you all look, you know, happy and joyful, as do I. But I know that within us, there are some fears and doubts and worries and concerns about all kinds of things. So Jeremiah says, trust. Last week I mentioned a song by Bob Marley, don't worry, be happy. Easier said than done. Doesn't work for me, I don't know. I have to work at not worrying. But week one, we looked at the beautiful, the birds, and look at the birds of the sky. They do not sow, they do not reap. And yet, and I'm paraphrasing, God's eye is on the sparrow. So don't worry. Trust in God. All right. Last week, we had flowers. And one of the messages from this, consider the lilies of the field, Jesus said. They do not work and they do not spin. And yet King Solomon in all of his splendor was not attired like one of these. And if that is how God clothes the grass, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown on the fire, will not God all the more clothe you? All right, so that's week one and week two. Week three, we've got Jeremiah saying on this next line, they who trust, or you who trust, we who trust, will be like a tree planted by the water that sends its roots out into the stream. What an image. To trust, to let go, to let God, which is hard, is as if we are planted next to this flowing stream with roots that run so deep, and there's a stream right next to it, okay, that no matter how high it gets, no matter if there's a drop, we are okay. What a beautiful message for us today. and trees, just like us, as you know, have water flowing through them. All creatures have waters flowing through them, all plants. But, you know, the physiology of the tree, remember in science class, or maybe some of you are botanists or biologists or chemists, but this old xylem and phloem, those are two great words. I've never seen them in a song yet, but I'm looking for one. So the xylem takes the water. It's like the circulatory system of the tree. And the xylem takes the water up, and it goes through the tree. And then, of course, the tree has the leaves and the sun, and the chlorophyll happens, and the phloem, nutrients, and it comes down. It's happening right now. Just like all of the stuff in our body is happening right now as we sit here. For all that, I say amen and such gratitude. So, the tree, quite amazing. But us, our bodies, 70% water. So our brains, I found out, are 70% water. Oh, there could be a lot of jokes about that. our lungs are 90% water. Wow. And then, you know, all the organs and all the water flowing there in our cells, of course, the blood, the circulatory system. Just to mention a few, of course, water helps us, kidneys, and eliminates waste. And, of course, water helps us to sweat and to cool us down. 70% of us is water. Gratitude. That brings us to song number two, which is, "There's a River Flowing in My Soul." I love this because you can take that line, "There's a river flowing in my soul," any way that you want. That could be, "There's water flowing through my body, and amen, thank you, God. I am healthy and I'm whole." And what an amazing miracle. Or the river could be God. There's a river, the river, the God of life is flowing through. You can take this so many ways. I love that third line. "There's a river flowing in my soul, and it's telling me that I'm somebody." Oh, like God said, my eye is on you, even if you are a sparrow. How many times do we feel like a nobody? Probably too many times. But this song, and of course God, is telling us you are somebody. Will you sing this with me? And it's a rocking one. So if you know it, join in. If not, enjoy the song and join in when you can. All right. "There's a river flowing in my soul. There's a river flowing in my heart. talking about our bodies being 70% water. So there was a scientist, there is a scientist, he's still alive. His name is Dr. Masaru Emoto from Japan. I'm not going to give you a lot of information about it, but you can certainly Google or look on your computer. There's books, there's videos about this. and Dr. Emoto was fascinated with the 70% water. And he also knew that through his training, I'm going to look right here. Human vibrational energy, such as thoughts, words, actions, deeds, affect the molecular structure of water. Whoa. If you believe that, that's mind-boggling. That our thoughts, our words, our actions, our thoughts even, affect water. And if we're 70% water, and the planet is 70% water, but let's just look at ourselves. Our thoughts affect the makeup of our body. Our thoughts can affect the makeup of someone else's body. We've always known that if we think unkind thoughts, people are going to sense that. But to know that they really cellularly perhaps change, that through this scientist, Dr. Emoto, he said, yes, there's changes. He says that water exposed to loving words shows brilliant, complex, crystallized patterns. And he says that water exposed to negative words, negative thoughts, negative actions, they are incomplete. They are asymmetrical patterns, and they're downright ugly. Wow. Speak well of others. And speak well of ourselves, right? Look at this first image. I'm not going to spend too much time on this, but look at that first one. So Dr. Emoto put water in test tubes. He exposed, for example, on this first one, the test tube, to thank you. And what you can read about how he did that. And then, after hours, he froze it. And then he took portions of it, he put it under a certain scope, took pictures of it, and found that just saying the word thank you does that for us. Look at that beautiful thing. Look at wisdom and truth. Beautiful words like eternal, angel. Now, do you see the I love you image, that crystal there? It's in the second row, second box. I have that image. It's about this big, it's framed, and it's in my office. And when I look at that image, I am reminded that what I say, what I do, and what I think affects everyone, including myself. So I am inspired by these amazing images here, and by the amazing God who has created all of these things. Look at these other images, peace, after the I love you. But then, he shows water that's been exposed to, and I'm gonna sound rough now. You fool! You fool! Dr. Emoto says that affects a person's water inside, and it looks ugly and shimmery, like, you know, in a bad way, shaky. Look at that third one, you make me sick, evil. And then he shows two images of polluted water, and he talks about this is not just praying over the polluted water and suddenly it'll be better, but no, followed by action. You can read more about that. Look at image two. There's some more there. Compassion, thank you, wisdom, truth, joy, love, eternal, harmony, hope, angel, soul. Look at image three, if you would. Thank you. There it is. There's a thank you again. There's you made me sick in image three. Love and appreciation. And I put this one in here, image three, down at the bottom, that water molecule before prayer and the water molecule after prayer. And if you're not a prayer, just substitute the word water before meditation, or water before silence, or water before my meditation walk, and water after. Look what it does inside of us. Image four is Dr. Emoto exposed, as a musician, this was fascinating, exposed water to music, to beautiful songs by Beethoven and Mozart and Bach. Look at the crystalline images. And then, I don't know what Dr. Moto played about Elvis, because I'm an Elvis fan. I know many of you are too. It's disjointed a little bit. Maybe there was something in the music that was really high-pitched. And then Japanese pop, very high-pitched instruments, and heavy metal, very loud, very loud. Look at those ugly, look at that heavy metal. So I just found this fascinating. And when I'm thinking and praying to God with gratitude for the water within me, I think of these crystals, and they make a difference to me. There is a poem that says, "One little word of kindness on someone's ear may fall like rays of golden sunshine that brightly shines for all." So, wow. I'm going to leave here today, watching what I say, watching what I think, watching what I do, not just watching, but I'm going to try. This is a quote from Philippians 4, verse 8, and it's about our thoughts, our words, and our deeds. It says, "Whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things." So that Jeremiah reading helps me in many ways. It helps me to let go, helps me to let God, and it helps me to remember that I am like a tree planted beside the water, that God will take care of me. Now, I have these cards with these crystals on them, and I would love for you to have one and take it with you. Take it with you, and perhaps, it will kind of remind you like it does me. If you get one and you're not like, I wish I had a different one, there may be some in the basket afterwards. So could I hand this to you? You can take top one and then pass it on. When you look at these images, may you be in awe and wonder for all that is surrounding us and around us. On the back is the word that Dr. Emoto and his team use to achieve that particular image. And that is my 10-minute warning, and we're right on schedule. Are there any cards left? And someone, are there any folks who didn't get a card? Great, did you get some cards? Okay. Great. And Margaret, if you could let me know how many more cards I have right here. And Anyone else need a card? Going once, twice? One more card, Margaret. Could you raise your hand if you did not get a card? All right, so take those with you. And may they be a challenge to each of us. This next song, song number 3. Oh, do you know this, Bridge Over Troubled Water? You know, I chose it not just because it talks about water, but because it says that what we do and how we are to each other really matters. Will you sing this with me? Or let it just bathe over your heart. When Moses' successor Joshua, they They all crossed the Jordan River, and they were no longer wanderers, but they were now an established nation. So just like the Jordan River crossing of the Israelites, Jordan River is deep and wide, alleluia. Milk and honey on the other side, alleluia. Right? Milk and honey on the other side. So, it might also remind you of Jesus' baptism. And this song, which we'll do, let's do two verses of this, down in the river to pray. It might remind you of your own baptism, or the baptism of Jesus, or just the wonder of water. Can we just sing this? As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. Next verse. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Now we sing brothers. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. Well, before we have our closing poem and song, my goodness, I had to think about what would be a nice giveaway today. Week one, as you left, I gave bird seed. We said, feed the birds, feed the world. Last week, we had flower bookmarks with Bible passages on it. So today I thought, well, it would be appropriate to hand out water. But I said, wait a minute. Water is not, luckily, that uncommon. We are so blessed that water is right there for us. But then I thought, water from a special place. What place would be special to people who come to a musical Bible study? I thought the Jordan River. And you know what? You can get Jordan River water. So I sent away for it. So, believe it or not, all right. Look. Each of these vials has a bit of Jordan River in it. And when we look, you know, I'm going to put this on my bedstand, I think. And when I look at this, I'm not just going to think of the Jordan River, but I will. I'll think of all that happened around the Jordan River. I'll think of the Jews, and I'll think of the Christians, and I'll think of the Muslims. I'll just think of everything, all the Bible stories that I know about that. But I'll also think of the water within, and I'll think of the waters of creation. So I'm excited to pass these out to you all. And as I pass these out to you, let's keep singing this one. As I went down to the river to pray, because we got to sing about fathers and mothers. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, fathers, let's go down, let's come on down. Oh, fathers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down into the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. This poem, the river cannot go back. Perhaps this will mean something literal for you. The river can only go toward the ocean. Or it might be talking about life. May I read it as we close today? It is said that before entering the sea, a river trembles with fear. She looks back at the path she has traveled, peaks of the mountains, a long winding road, crossing forests and villages. And in front of her, she sees an ocean so vast that to enter there seems nothing more than to disappear forever. But there is no other way. The river cannot go back. Nobody can go back. To go back is impossible in existence. The river needs to take the risk of entering the ocean, because only then will fear disappear. Because that's where the river will know it's not about disappearing into the ocean, but of becoming the ocean. With God's help, as we leave here, may we have the courage to go forward in life, to cross over the rivers, the troubled waters that we find, and may we know that it's forward ahead, full speed ahead, and God is with us. Let's sing our closing song here. I got peace like a river, I got joy like a fountain, and I've got love like an ocean. I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river, I've got peace like a river in my soul. Joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got joy like a fountain in my soul. Love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean in my soul. I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean, I've got love like an ocean in my soul. Go forth from here with the love in our hearts, pouring forth like the ocean. I hope, thank you for coming, and I hope to see you next week. Next week is about gardening. It's fruit, vine, and trellis. So I hope to see you next week. Thank you, one and all. Welcome, everybody.